Welcome to Black and White Overnight, Game Show Network's salute to the bygone era of classic game shows, featuring some of your favorite stars of stage and screen.
One of these men is the manager of the heavyweight champion of the world. What is your name, please?
My name is Cus D'Amato.
What is your name, please?
My name is Cus D'Amato.
What is your name, please?
My name is Cus D'Amato.
Two of these people are imposters. Only one is the real Cus D'Amato and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. And now, here is our host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to Tell the Truth.
Stay tuned. There's more Black and White Overnight coming right up.
Now may I introduce our panel. What is your name, please?
My name is Polly Vernon.
My name is Ralph Bellamy.
My name is Kitty Carlisle.
My name is Tom Poston.
I'm sorry. No, I'm not. If I was a little extra exuberant, but welcome home, Polly.
Thank you. It is so good to be back.
I saw your show First Impressions the other night, and I was just a doggone proud of you. You thought I owned you. Brought the whole family. Oh, except one. Got to come back with her now and have her.
Good.
It's just great and a joy.
Thank you.
See, with the two of you now, you and Ralph Bellamy and Sunrise and Campabella, what are we going to do? Kitty, something for you and Tom and Miss... Well, that'll leave me
Tom's
here.
Tom's got it. Got it.
I'm so glad Polly's back. Thank you.
I'm working on something, Bud.
Yes, you are. What are you working on? What is it, Tom?
I don't know whether I should tell you now.
Yeah, tell me. It's off Broadway, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It's called Come Play With Me. It's a musical.
Yeah. Well, say. All righty. Now, that was... And good luck. And now, panel, will you please follow along with your copies of this very first affidavit as I read it to you.
What are the rules?
You've forgotten them. You'll catch on. I, Cus D'Amato, have been in the prize fight business for more than 30 years. I own a gymnasium here in New York, and I have trained or managed more than 500 boxers. I am perhaps best known as the manager of the world's heavyweight champion, Floyd Patterson, signed Cus D'Amato. All right, panel, you just heard these three gentlemen all claim to be Cus D'Amato, manager of heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson. Let's start tonight's questioning with, welcome home, Polly Vergen.
Number two, what do you say to a fighter between the rounds? I always see you talking.
Fight harder.
Fight harder. Number three, there is a prize fighter who's won three different championships. What is his name?
Henry Armstrong.
Henry Armstrong. Number one, there's a man who's held three different champion titles. What is his name?
Henry Armstrong.
Number two, what is Jersey Joe Walcott's real name?
Arnold Cream.
Number three, who did Mr. Patterson win the championship from?
Archie Moore.
Archie Moore. Number one, did Archie Moore ever fight under any other weight?
He fights under the light heavyweight. He's the light heavyweight champ.
Ralph Bellamy.
Number one, what ex-champion very successfully went into the grocery business? Number two, can you answer that question? Number three, do you know? Well, I'll tell you, it's Jess Willard.
I've heard of him.
Number one, where is Stillman's gym?
54th Street and 55th Street. On 8th Avenue.
Number two, what very important announcement did Mr. Stillman recently make?
That he was going to retire, but he didn't yet.
Number three, where is your gym?
14th Street, Manhattan.
Kitty Carlisle.
Number one, it's sort of known that fighters can lose about 10 pounds in a day or so. It's a very valuable secret. What would I have to do to lose this kind of weight?
Well, I would think that you'd have to punch a punching bag. Spar a few rounds with the spa mates.
Yes.
Run 3 or 4 miles a day.
Yes.
and keep on a low-calorie diet.
It's easy.
Very easy.
I'll start tomorrow. Number two,
let's
what
start
is...
with the last one first, Kitty.
What does Cus really stand for?
Constantine.
Constantine, not cuss words.
No cuss words.
Number three, who's promoting your next fight?
Cecil Rhodes.
Number one, Cecil Rhodes.
Yes,
that is distinguished.
Tom Poston, please.
He is.
That's very interesting. Number three, who is promoting your next championship fight?
Is that a question for me?
Number three, yeah. Who is promoting your next championship?
Oh, I thought that's the question I was just asked. Is that the...
Well, maybe he'd like to hear it again.
Oh. Well, I did answer Cecil Rhodes.
Well, let me put it this way, number three. What is... the name of the opponent for the championship match?
Brian London.
I see. I won't go into why I'm asking that question so significantly, but I didn't realize that the bell had just rung.
But I'll get him next round. Well, excuse me, Tom. And without consultation, will you mark your ballots? And in so doing, of course, as usual, select number one, number two, or number three. And the team of challengers will get $250 for every incorrect vote. Okay, panel all voted? How about you, Polly? For whom did you vote on your first trip back?
I voted for number two because he knew who Jersey Joe Walcott's real name was. I think he's the one I asked, because I don't remember too well, but I think it was him. And if it was, that's the one I vote for.
Nothing has changed. Ralph?
Number two. He seemed to know all the answers, and I think was a little quicker with it. And I think the way he said his name sounded more like it might be his name.
Okay. Kitty, what about your vote?
I voted for number two also because I thought he pronounced D'Amato as if he really had Italian background.
Mm-hmm. And Tom Poston, you pick out?
I didn't get a chance to ask any questions. I thought it was number three, but I would like to ask, if I may, later.
Okay, there we have it. For whatever reasons we made up our minds the way we did, you've heard them. And if you're playing along with us at home, as we trust you do each week, let's find out right now how right or wrong you may be. Now, I can't really think of a better way to unmask the true identity of which one of these gentlemen is the real Cus D'Amato than the heavyweight champion himself. So, ladies and gentlemen, Floyd Patterson. Floyd, a very warm welcome to you from us, as well as that one that must have warmed your heart from the audience out there. I wonder if you do us a favor now and let us know which one of these men is your real manager, Cus D'Amato. Thanks very much. Floyd, I'd like to ask you a question or two along with welcoming you here, and thank you for taking the time to come see us, because it seems to me I read in the paper within the last 2 or 3 weeks you had an addition to your family, didn't you?
Yes, I did, a girl.
A little girl?
Yes.
Now, does that make a boy and a girl?
No, two girls.
Two girls?
Yes.
Well, the next time is the charm time, because I had two girls and then a boy, so the next one will be the future heavyweight champion of the world. Who do you fight next?
Brian London, I believe. It will be sometime in April.
You want to reveal what round you're going to put him away in or not?
Well, I don't generally do that.
You don't do that. I know you don't. You're a very modest guy. Well, good luck to you. Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Along the same lines, I didn't realize, the reason I was pressing this so much, I didn't realize that the championship was going to be at stake in that match.
Mm-hmm.
Is it? Obviously it is.
Yes, it is. In any fight that I have, unless it's merely an exhibition, championship will be at stake.
Attaboy.
And may I add something to this question to clarify?
We're running short of time.
Yes. That this man he's fighting is ranked number four in the world ratings.
Well, number four.
Oh, I know he's a tough opponent. I thought that your deal with Rosenstone and
Guildenstern, yes, from Hamlet. I remember.
And Johansson precluded any previous heavyweight championship.
Would you tell us, number one, who you really are and what you do, please? Who are you, sir? What do you do?
My name is Peter Rossi. I'm the passenger representative for the French Line in New York City.
What about you?
My name is Nick Mazuris. I own the Neutral Corner Restaurant on West 55th Street.
Well, checking up on our score, we find that there are 1, 2, 3 incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $750 from Marlboro. Gentlemen, thank you very much for being with us. Floyd, thank you again, and kiss that baby for us, will you please? And give your wife our best also. And on your way out, you'll find a carton of Marlboro cigarettes for each of you. Good night and good luck. Lots of good luck in your next fight. I'd like to tell you that Floyd Patterson first put on boxing gloves when he was a student at the Wiltwyck School for Boys. Wiltwyck, which cares for 100 of the most underprivileged and troubled boys in New York City, is currently in the midst of a fundraising campaign. And Cus D'Amato has asked that we send his winnings along as a contribution in gratitude.